This is an example of applying differential equations to solve a problem that involves Newton's law of cooling. The question states, when a cup of coffee is first poured, it is measured at 90 degrees centigrade. 5 minutes later, it is cooled down to 88 degrees. What will the temperature be 25 minutes after it was first poured if the temperature of the room is 20 degrees centigrade? Use Newton's law of cooling that states that the rate of change of temperature is proportional to the difference between the object's temperature and the temperature of the surrounding medium. So let's first set up the differential equation. We've got the question here, and the important part is the following. Newton's law says that the rate of change of temperature, well, if temperature is y, then its rate of change is going to be dy over dt. Then it says is proportional to. Is proportional to means equals some constant, which I'll call k, and then times, and let's read what comes next. So let's find out what comes next. It says the difference between the object's temperature and the temperature of the surrounding medium. Well, the object's temperature, that's changing with time, that's y, our variable. And the temperature of the surrounding medium, well, the room is 20 degrees centigrade. So it's y minus 20. So putting this together, we get dy over dt is equal to k times, parentheses, y minus 20. So now let's solve this differential equation, dy dt equals k times y minus 20. First divide by y minus 20 and multiply by dt on both sides, and we get dy over y minus 20 equals k times dt. Now, this has a dy and a dt, it just wants to be integrated. So we integrate, and we get the integral of dy over y minus 20 equals the integral of k dt. So now, to integrate this left-hand side, we have a y minus 20 on the bottom, let that be u, and its derivative of y minus 20 is just 1, so we can say du is dy. So that gives us the integral of du over u is equal to k dt. The integral of du over u, that's just the natural log of the absolute value of u. The integral of k is k times t plus some constant. I'll call it c1. You'll see why they c1 for now. Notice that a constant, the integral of a constant is always a constant times time plus a constant. So now u was y minus 20, so I just plug in y minus 20 where I saw u. And then what I do is I exponentiate both sides with base e. The log goes away, the natural logarithm goes away, and we get e to the kt plus c1. Notice that it's e to the entire right-hand side. So then add 20 to both sides, and one more little trick, if you have e to the kt plus c1, that's the same as e to the kt times e to the c1. And if c1 is a constant and e is a constant, then e to the c1 is also a constant. Let's call that c. So that gives us y equals c e to the kt plus 20. Now let's continue. What we do next is let's find the constants c and k. So to do that, we read the original question. We're given that when it was first poured, that's at time equals 0, it was 90 degrees centigrade. In other words, y of 0 is 90. When t is 0, y is 90. And then we also know that after 5 minutes, it was 88 degrees. 5 minutes later, it cooled down to 88 degrees. So y of 5 equals 88. So for the first one, y of 0 equals 90, we plug in, 90 is our y, so we write y, which is 90, equals c e to the k, now t is 0, so I plug in 0, plus 20. E to the 0 is 1, so I get c plus 20 is 90. Subtracting 20 on both sides, we get c equals 70. So that tells us that this c right here is 70, and I can use the second condition, y of 5 is 88, and plug in. We get 88 equals 70, that was our c, times e to the k times our time is 5, plus 20. Subtract 20 from both sides, 88 minus 20 is 68, and divide by 70, and we get 68 over 70 equals e to the k times 5. Take a natural log of both sides, and we get the natural log of 68 divided by 70, equals 5 times k, and then finally divide by 5, that gives us our k, put it in our calculator, And that gives you 0.056 with a negative. So finally, our solution to the differential equation is y equals 70 e to the negative 0.056t plus 20. So now we're ready to answer our question. So the question, if you remember, it says, what will the temperature be 25 minutes after it was first poured? So that tells us t is 25, and we plug in 25 for t, and I put it into a calculator. So 70 times e to the negative 0.056 times 25 plus 20, put in a calculator, I get 37. So our answer is the coffee will be about 37 degrees centigrade after 25 minutes. And that was Newton's law of cooling and differential equations.